3JS tends to create what are called canonical objects. This is where you create an object centered around the origin and then apply a series of transforms to move it into position. This is fine so far as it goes, but is sometimes awkward when you want to perform particular kinds of modeling. For example, if I want to make a model where I want chains of cones to build a tree, I might rather say where I want each end of the cone to be located. This sort of modeling, where I run a program to generate an object, is called procedural modeling. I want to orient the cone given the top and bottom locations. That'll be your task. In the calling routine, the top and bottom variables are vector 3 positions giving the ends of the cone. You'll see documentation for the other variables in the code itself. Your task is to implement the internals of this method. Actually, I decided to simplify a major piece for you, mainly because it has a special case having to do with the cross product. I implemented this function myself, so your job is to create the proper length cylinder and feed this method its axis, direction, and center. When you get the answer right, you'll see this on your screen. I give a lot of test cones here, and in fact a few of these revealed some bugs in my own code when I was writing it. If you ever design a component like this that will be used by others, I highly recommend that you try to create as many different types of test cases as you can.